just gonna wait and see if anybody shows up. Hey, Michael. Thanks, man. I'm glad it works. Give it a minute, see if anybody else comes in. Let me know if audio is working all right. I have it muted on my stream so I don't get feedback. Or echo, rather. Alright, cool. Yeah, I'm epically nervous about this right now. Just being honest. Right now, on pace to be tied for first. So that's got me nervous, and first time streaming in forever. Double nervous. I know there's shots to be had, but we'll get on in. Actually, give me 1 minute.
Be right back.
All right.
My bad.
This has been a round that's been tricky to say the least. I haven't hit anything super consistently. But not many fatal mistakes. I've had some mistakes that were saved and a couple nice shots. Oh, son of a bitch. Starting great. All right, safe still. No biggie. No biggie. Uh, 36, I highly doubt. Maybe a 30 or 31 on a good day. But we'll see. If I can get a couple of the drops I haven't been able to get yet. Oh. This has been one of them holes. Close a bunch and haven't dropped it. Yeah, it's short. And left. Thanks for joining, guys. Appreciate it. I forget how the copyright shit works. I hope it just messes up this being a future video. I don't care about that. Thanks, Steve. It's not going to be like it was. I'll probably stream weekend rounds here and there. That's about it. Life is too busy to stream like I used to. I feel this is kind of nostalgic though, because right when I was kind of, I guess you could say, at my peak of streaming was right around when they released Porthello Cove. So my first stream back being here is kind of iconic, as much as it's going to probably be brutal, but we'll try. I'm just hoping for a top 10 ultimately. I'd really like to get a top 3, so replay some of these balls, but been back playing for a month, so that feels a little far-fetched. Yeah, and it's not like I'm starting completely green. There is some level of like riding a bike kind of mentality. But relearning the holes has proven to be a bitch. The extra pressure is because Pufferfish never even podiumed an expert. I've gotten a few top tens, but Bird Hunter was always the account that seemed to pull off the wins. And I'm sure there's probably, like, the best score is always one of the last to play for some stupid reason. So I'm willing to bet someone's going to shoot 29 through 32, you know, maybe even more than a couple people. Yeah, it's a chore. Still mostly play off. Oh, a little rough clip. Expert 2, Steve. I shouldn't have put that little click of right spin or right curl. Still, I could be shooting from the rough like my opponent. I'll take the easy putt. So we need ideally 3 drops here in the back 9. I mean, more would be better, but that would put me standalone in first for the time being. Nope, 228. Oh yeah, that guy's gonna, yeah, see, I figured as much. There's a probably minus 31. I thought I had another one. This is definitely a must-have hole here. Why is that? That's a bummer. Thanks, Ron. Definitely a further wedge shot than I'd like because I suck at wedge shots. I got on green in my opening round. Ironically, I think I hit great right on opening round. Knowing that, I should have lined up a little more right, but I never know if I'm going to actually hit perfect on overpower. Alright, so right here. Son of a bitch. I am a master at missing those, I tell you. I think this next hole is probably my second least favorite hole of the course. Thanks, Terry. This one in Billy Goat Bluff, the par 3. Hate those holes. I mean, generally speaking, most of these holes suck. And I just blew the easiest, well, yeah, no, I'd say that was the easiest potential drop. So what's everyone's best round so far on this tournament? Whew, nice, Terry. It would take a hell of a last few holes to get me to minus 32. Probably just going to be out of... That's true, MBS. Top 100 all the way. I mean, I should be, like, outside of really blowing it, I should be top 25 or 30, I would think, no matter what. Like, with a minus 12. One or two drops from here and no mistakes, and I would be it. I'd be a happy man. Perfect was in. Motherfucker. Story of my life. I'll be right back. I'm gonna grab a drink. I will say I'm super freaking grateful that they got rid of the shootouts and entry fee per hole. Great freaking change by their part. I miss fucking Fun and James, by the way, Mike. One of my favorites to tune into, for sure. Yeah, I saw that RJ was streaming other stuff. I haven't checked into any of them. He usually does it when I'm in the middle of something else. I mean, pretty much, almost all the original people that I came in with have stopped. Is this the minus 10%? It is, isn't it? If you're adjusting into the sand trap. The first time I had to write myself notes. Usually I know the holes so well, it's all mental, but. I almost want to start playing Bird Hunter again just to get practice rounds in. But the clubs aren't the same, and so not everything, and I don't have the same balls in both accounts, so it's never like one for one, but. Fingers crossed, I think I botched that. Yep. Should have done the minus 10%, I think. Maybe my distance was off. Yeah, no, this is my least favorite hole coming up. I hate this fucking hole. Truly hate it. I thought they reduced the elevation a little bit. It doesn't seem like they did. Not from what I remember, anyways. Why I'm not doing that on this shot. Whatever. I hate this fucking hole. Even something like that. Little putt, not perfect, would have been terrible. All right. Really could use a drop right around now. Good luck with a question mark is probably just as legitimate, man. Just being honest. Three holes left. I need three drops, essentially. I got boned on this hole on the opening round, so I'm hoping that's not the case now. Well, thank you, Mr. Michael Bolton. Welcome here. I am by no means the greatest Golf Clash player, but can hold my own. I imagine in a few more tournaments, I'll be back to where I used to be. But all right, so cross fingers on this one. Come on. Damn it. Last time I did the full right, one bar right spin, and ended up in the rough on the right. So, you know, slice shots. Now I need to save big time. Son of a bitch. Well, gonna be very middle of the road this tournament. Back nine killed me. See what I get for streaming, guys? Now, the best chance of the drop on this course was hole 12 or something of that, where the one power five wind zero send it to the green shot that I clipped the rough in by a hair. That was the best chance. This one is a good chance, but the wind on the second round is kind of fucked for it. Need a miracle. I aced this next hole on the front nine, which means I will not ace it again, and I've yet to drop 18. So we're looking at, I mean, it would put me in probably somewhere between 10th and 12th right now. Really need this drop. depending what happens here, I may waste practice tokens on the next hole trying to figure out my game plan, because thanks, talent. Not been a good back nine. Very mediocre. Son of a bitch. Probably was still missing, but I'll... Dude! Geek, what is up, my homie? Yeah, those par three. Every par three on this course sucks. There is no, like, good one. Certain wind conditions, that first one can be all right, but this course sucks for par threes. Problem is, I botched the par fours that are doable. The par fives here, I always fuck up. Well, I don't always fuck up, but I rarely get an albatross. It's usually like either second shot is a tough spot to get to eagle, but it's fine, or just straight eagle, because I missed my albatross. I'll be right back for the last hole. So, one thing I'm curious about is practice holes. It gives me 1 through 9. So, is it the variable wind through 1 through 9, or is it going to give me the wind that I would get on 18 because I'm now past the front 9? I don't want to waste the time if it's just going to be a different wind. So it's going to give me random wind, right? Yeah, it's variable wind. So it doesn't even matter. Oh, okay. Hold on. Continue tournament. Play hole. Now practice. I got you. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Because I can take the safe route with the Guardian. But I have, like, I almost never drop Guardian shots. I don't know what it is about that club. I'll get in there within a yard or two, usually, but never drop them. So I'm kind of curious to see if I can pull off a power slice here. The wind, so we go this ball, I think I want to just go like that. I've been doing it with the overpower before and it wasn't really doing me any favors. See, that's beautiful right there. That's beautiful. That's the way we play this, I think. This is probably long iron shot, no? So I say, I gotta stop following other people's shit. I just gotta learn the courses better again. Because it's short iron, really. It's so different trying to follow someone else compared to going with your gut. Oh, yeah, no shit. There's my min. Max. So we've got about 33% or so. We are out there. 7.4 at 33%. Watch me drop this. Like, should have just done it. Nope. Okay, good. Sort of okay, good. Because I still have a chance to botch it on the real hole, but... this would have been more like 35%, but, I mean... likely not going to be the exact same on my shot for real anyway, so. Or we do minus 5% elevation. We really need it. I need this drop. It's big. This is a top 10 or not to make the shot, I think. That was lucky. Practice don't matter, but... all right. Tournament. Okay, yeah. I need it. Twenty-five percent elevation or 25% club? assuming you mean club. Oh, interesting. Were you in the same ballpark? I think you need more elevation, though, in Master of the Higher Wind. Because it's a thorn, so that second ball bounce is higher. Because I overshot, or I over-adjusted by an eighth of an arc or whatever it was. All right, so 7, 9, 6.5 rings. Right there. Fingers crossed for me. Oh my God, that's probably exact. Because it's probably 30 yards further from Masters tee, I would assume. All right, so you said 25% elevation. And then at true club distance. So if I'm at 50% distance, 50, then we're good. No tweaking. Eight back, one right. Let's see. Over on the right, but don't have time to measure it out any closer. Cross fucking fingers. Son of a great left. Fucking damn it. Fucking damn it. It was there. Or at least would have been really goddamn close. Pitiful back nine. I apologize, everybody. The four people watching. Literally parred the back nine. I know, it had a chance. Fucking clock always gets me like that. When I'm down to the 3 seconds or less, I almost always hit great. Bummer. Off of a really good front nine. Really good by my standards right now, anyways. Pitiful back nine. Well, my guess with how many people are left, it'll probably be somewhere between 20 and 30, which isn't the worst. At least I still get the 25 Kingmakers, but God damn it. Because, I mean, it's like 10 through 20, the prizes don't change enough, in my opinion. You should still be getting, like,
I don't know, it should be like 25 Kingmakers and 50 Titans or something like that then. Like, reverse the two. That sucks. Because I'm not going to get 11th anyways. I would bet somewhere around 20. But thanks for tuning in, guys. Disappointed in myself, but is what it is. Getting top 25 in my first stream back and first time, it's like my fourth tournament back, including 9-hole cups, so, eh. Just sucks because I had it set to be top 10 for sure. One or two drops is all I needed. Hurts, but thanks, guys.